Inconvenient Truth. Joseph was a cuck. So adult mentality needed for this video and pretty much all the content on my channel. And this is probably the sort of video where I this is now made me unhireable by a vast number of people. Some of you have probably already left, huffing and puffing and be like, I can't believe this person said this. This is sacrilege. I can't believe, damn it, did God strike you down? No, God's not going to strike me down. I don't believe in your God. And if you do believe in your God, I'm just going off of the stories that were being told by what happened to Joseph of Arimathea and one Mary of Nazareth, mother of Jesus, who is supposedly God made flesh. And in some of the actual writings, depending on who you're actually referring to here, born of a virgin human being who was probably under the age of consent. But I guess the age of consent is different back then in the Middle East. I don't know. Let's just get back to the topic here. People literally mean things figuratively, especially when they're talking about political issues, and especially Americans. This is one thing that I've noticed. And one thing I have seen is a lot of people on the political right seem to say this more, saying you are cucking, you are a cuckold. They call people on the political left. And not just because of the different kinds of relationships that some people who seem to lean more progressive have, like these stories where like, yeah, I'm living in this house with four other men who are married to this one woman, and it's like, eh, wow, that's an odd situation. But is that necessarily outright cucking? In this case, if you are also cucking the other men back, then can you be a cuck? Can you switch between the cucker and the cucky? I don't know what this thing is. Anyway, let me go to knowyourmeme.com because I think it's a great site, and I think people normally use this in the slang sense. So let's get a better understanding of the term being used in that slang sense. So about cuck, short for cuckold, is a term referring to a man with a female significant other who engages in sexual activities with other men. Online, the term is often used as a pejorative to condescendingly describe a male who is sexually inadequate or sexually submissive. Now, there is another four-letter C word that is referred to mostly towards females that they often say this is gendered abuse. You don't have these, but this cuck is, I haven't really heard cuck being used towards a woman. I guess it can in some sense, it might be able to. Maybe it had to be in a lesbian relationship. I don't know what kind of situation it would be, but I find this to be a rather gendered insult, a rather gendered word in that sense. Is it the equivalent? Do you think it's the equivalent of the four-letter C word for women? Let me know what you think. Okay, now back to the reading. The origin. It says the world here, but come on now, know your meme. Get some editors here. The word cuckold originated in 1250 in the satirical poem The Owl and the Nightingale, and is derived from the cuckoo bird, referring to some species. Is it cuckoo or cuckoo? Cuck. Cuckoo. 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 Cuckoo bird. Is this a cuckoo bird or the cuckoo bird? Referring to some species of the animal that practice brood parasitism. On January 18th, 2007, Urban Dictionary user Feener submitted an entry for the word for the term cuck, defining it as a shortened form of cuckold. Now spread. This is one of the good things about this site. They tell you about the spread and you can track it and everything. So I'll just give the first example here. So Aaron Johnny published a Zoe post expose. Now Zoe post, that's Zoe Quinn, who was involved in the Five Guys situation with some corruption or some supposed insider sexing, in preferential treatment or things like that, where she was having some intimate relations with different people who were in video game journalism, and then they might have given her video game some favorable reviews. And this came out, I remember first hearing it from like Internet Aristocrat, and it blew up. And then it was one of the things that kind of started the Gamergate, Comics Gate type of things. But yeah, anyway, so there is that. So it says in an expose in 2014, which detailed the alleged infidelity of his girlfriend, Zoe Quinn, many 4chan users began using, referring to Jonji as a cuck. On August 25th of 2014, Jonji participated in an Ask Me Anything thread on the subreddit drama, r-drama subreddit, where he discussed being called a beta cuck. and posted a photoshopped image of Quinn and several men with the caption "cocktails," which is shown below. And it's this interesting thing where the people who normally steal stuff from Scrooge McDuck and whatnot are the little thugs, are people like the Reddit face, the Twitter face, the 4chan logo, and then now the four people on the actual plane who are supposed to be like Scrooge McDuck's like launch pad McDuck, I forget the names, and then Scrooge McDuck hanging off the airplane as Zoe Quinn. Funny image. But so that is it with the cuck thing. So we hear people calling other people cuck a lot. It is mostly, from what I've noticed, mostly on the political right calling people on the political left a cuck. When you go again into the more adult entertainment area, there's actually an entire series of cuckold porn where it's normally, there seems to be more of a, now this could just be because there's more people, there's more actual demographics of white men watching it. So there seems to be more of an interracial bent on this where it's a white female is cucking her white male towards a black male coming in and having relations with her. And this goes into the extra worship thing or worship this black god. And the, oh, there's this thing I watched. I forget what it is. Some new YouTube channel. I just found this channel. This guy, this is the awkward guy, he's an interviewer. He goes to the AVN, I think the Adult Video Network or Adult Video Network or something, awards. It's like the Grammys for porn. And there's different people there, convention goers. And there was one of them who was going into the whole play where she actually had some white men on a leash walking around, and some black guy was just there. He seemed to just say, I just came in to check what this or that. There was free alcohol, so I'm here drinking. But he was actually caught up in some kind of interaction with this woman who was saying she's a slave master, and this man was cucking, and it's like, oh, worship this black god. Don't you want to see this black god with me? And so there's this whole aspect where it's this the worship that gets into there. But it's also often said that, look, Europe is cucking themselves out because people from other places in Africa, in Middle East, in Asia, are coming into the white countries and cucking the men by taking their women. So there's this aspect of it in there that I see in some certain salt right aspects of the internet, of the information sphere, of the communication sphere. And to those people, a lot of them are religious. A lot of them are specifically Christian. But their religion is based on an interaction that by the loosest definition of what I've seen most of them use this term for is based on cuckoldry. Now, there's other things you might be able to say it's based on. You might say like, oh, this is God. It's different. There was no actual intercourse. This was, but come on. When you go into those things and you're saying, is that our creator? Is that our father? Is that some kind of incest type of stuff? There's a lot of questions that are raised with this. So I'm just saying, if you do believe in calling people cucks, then Joseph of Arimathea was a cuck. And that's it for this one. Hopefully this doesn't get banned. This might get banned, or it might lose me actual viewers. It's definitely something that would probably lose me any potential work with certain people who believe certain strong things about this. And I'm not trying to be entirely this explicitly blasphemous here, but that's just I'm just reading the lay of the land. I'm just comparing and contrasting what people say versus what actually was supposedly to have happened. So let me know what you think in the comment section. Like if you did like it, dislike if you disliked it. There's also links to a merchandise store. I don't think I can get away with writing Joseph was a cuck on a shirt. I might be able to, but this might be a reason for me to actually just go independent while you're deciding what's in the shirt for myself. I think some people would actually wear that shirt in different places. And I'm also thankful that most Christians, despite the things that they believe in that I disagree in, are not at the point where you'd actually get killed for actually saying something like that. Because there are some people who still would kill you for saying way less about the people they believe in. And not too long ago, Christians were in the killing mood for this very same thing. But yeah, it's a better world we live in now. Till next time, goodbye.